This event, ladies and gentlemen, has a 20-minute time limit and features first Gary Hart's new giant from Queens, New York, 287 pounds, the Dingo Warrior. Behind me in the blue tight stands his opponent from Arlington, Texas, 237 pounds, Brian Adias. Bronco Lovitz, your referee.
And this edition of World Class Championship Wrestling featuring the great Dingo Warrior and Brian Adias. And sitting in with me is David Manning, referee extraordinaire, and a lot of other great accolades you could say about wrestling. Nice to have you along, David.
Thank you, Bill.
You know, David, I guess I remember as a child that we used to have those Charles Atlas deals in the magazines, and you could get a body that looked like the one the Dingo Warrior has put together there. But I think it's tough. Yeah, I thought it was impossible that I saw that one.
Yeah, they were always cartoon characters. You wouldn't imagine a guy really looking like this.
That is
he is awesome.
He really is fantastic and extremely difficult to bring down. But if anybody can do it, Brian Adias, a young man from Arlington, Texas, by way of Denton County and friends of the Von Erichs since childhood. But this should be an interesting one as the Dingo Warrior, another one of Gary Hart's proteges, is really moving along nicely. A young man in this business, isn't he, David?
Yeah, he is. You know, he's former Texas heavyweight champion. And Brian, you know, he's been around, and if anybody can outsmart this Dingo, that's the key. You can't go out there and try to out-muscle him or, use power against him. You got to out-wrestle him, and that's what Brian's going to try to do in this match.
And Brian, there is a tremendous strength of the Dingo Warrior, but Adias has that timing down and moves aside. Tremendous physique. As Gary Hart was telling us, that the Dingo Warrior coming out of Queens, New York, built up this body and then would go on the subways to sort of see if anybody challenged him.
Well, Bill, you know, Dingo, they were in the big tag team tournament for the world title. And his Sacco. Partner, Sacco, that's yeah. Right. And Sacco, they won two matches, and then Sacco got defeated. And Dingo couldn't handle it. They end up carrying Sacco out because Dingo jumped on him and really did a number on him.
He cannot stand to lose, can he?
Bad sport.
The Dingo Warrior. There's Gary Hart. You know, it's interesting that Gary Hart has a really good-looking young man with him. He always brings in some of the world's most obscene-looking characters to work for him.
I think, you know, he's always got something new. Brian, good move by Brian. I thought he was going to get a chance to get a 1-2. You don't see too many of those on Dingo.
It would be very difficult to hold him in that position.
Yeah, he's so powerful. His legs, every part on him. Some guys have a large upper body or large legs. Everything on him is just, picture perfect.
Gary Hart says that he works out twice a day to keep that muscle tone and the strength going.
I can believe that. You know, they get a lot of great matches tonight. The World Tag Team Tournament last week. It's too bad the weather's so bad outside. I was in the back before I came out here. They've been closed down about three roads because of the high water. It's really a shame some of the people couldn't get out here tonight.
Well, Texas doesn't really have seasons. It has weather. And we get everything all at once. You get all the water at once, or you get all the wind at once. Look at this
Look at his power.
Straight up over his head. He's lifted 245 pounds. That is the amazing strength, the amazing work of the Dingo Warrior, who just is practically impossible to fight through him. I don't know how you'd attack him except by maybe quickness.
Well, when he gets you up there, too, you're just almost helpless. You know, you can't really start jumping around. You're liable to take a bad fall and dislocate a shoulder. I tell you, Brian, this crowd's behind him, too, 100%.
The Dingo Warrior. I notice that a lot of fans applaud him when he's introduced, and I guess it is kind of envious just because of that tremendous physique of his and his appearance.
Yeah, that, you know, a lot of the girls, even with paint on, say he's awesome chop to the chest.
Just tremendous.
You know, you know, the rumors in the wrestling world, you just did that interview, I had heard the rumors all week, and a lot of other wrestlers have, about Rick Rude and Percy, but I guess they weren't rumors. Percy just clarified that.
Percy Pringle and Rick Rude have broken their partnership, and that's really interesting. I can imagine that the bit began to crumble after that championship match when Chris Adams won, and Percy Pringle kind of interfered in the wrong way.
Yeah, he cost more or less cost Rick the match. Right. I'm not saying Chris Adams wouldn't have won, but Percy definitely didn't help him out that night, and he also didn't help him out last week.
Well, those things can test your patience and also you kind of question whether you're dealing with the right individual.
Brian's going to have to make a... He's going to have to really get pumped up right here. Oh, and there's that clothesline.
That's like running into a stone wall at full speed, and that's when it won.
Maybe
two. Nope. Brian fighting his way out of there. Here's a young man with tremendous determination not to lose, Brian Adias. Gary Hart has been very quiet. Of course, he doesn't have to say a lot with the Dingo Warrior in there.
No, Gary pretty quiet. You know, last week, I think in the near future, they're going to get to see that match over here last week with Abdullah and Brody, and Fritz was in Brody's corner. That's going to be a real treat for the fans to World Class Championship Wrestling. That's going to be coming up in the near future. What a night it was, Bill. I have to give Buzz Sawyer and Matt Bourne credit. They defeated a lot of good teams, and there were some controversial finishes, but, you know, it all boils down. They got the world belts right now.
And Gary Hart and Fritz Von Erich, anytime they're in the same arena, there's got to be a lot of electricity. You just saw Diaz come back, and then the Dingo Warrior stopped him in his tracks, drops out 285 pounds on him, and comes in for a reverse chin lock. So the Dingo Warrior is managing to kind of contain this bout right now. He really is.
He's going to have to meet someone, you know, that's close to his strength and, and knows the wrestling ability. I'm anxious to see him and a Kevin Von Erich. Or him and Lance Von Erich, or him and Bruiser Brody, because then you've got...
Or when Kerry comes back.
That's exactly right.
Yeah.
Kerry, they're close to the same size, you know. I don't know too many people in the world stronger than Kerry.
No, when you speak of physique, you got to speak of Kerry Von Erich also. Ed Carey's coming along nicely.
Doing great, Bill. I saw him over the weekend. The foot's coming along. He's already back in that gym training, and you know how dedicated they are, and the fact that he's not getting around too good, that doesn't stop him from pumping those weights, and mentally he's watching the tapes and wanting to get back out here with the fans.
As Gary Hart giving a few instructions to Bronco Lubitsch and the Dingo Warrior as Brian Adias wraps in with the Dingo Warrior. Interesting. You know, the dingo, if you do not know, is a wild, vicious dog in Australia. So it kind of fits that the nickname of this man is the Dingo Warrior. He's a rather wild and certainly dangerous individual with those tremendous chops.
Hammer. You got to call that a hammer. Oh, he missed that knee. Brian needs to come up right now if he's going to get away. He's had two chances.
Brian Adias has done that three times, moving out of the way. Here comes Brian Adias rolling back now with the Dingo Warrior. A good elbow into the neck.
Boy, this guy's hard to put down. That may get no.
Another drop kick, and he's down this time. Brian Adias after him here. Brian Adias up and look out over the top rope. That might be it. It is. Now that was the intent of the Dingo Warrior to toss Adias over the top rope. Protesting vehemently is Gary Hart. Hart is really upset.
Yeah, it's a questionable call whether it was accidental or, you know, he was intentional. But it's Bronco's decision, and I believe I'd have to agree with him here.
Yeah, I think if you looked at the replay of that, you would see the right arm of the Dingo Warrior come up and help Brian Adias up over the top rope. Hart says he was robbed, but the official winner is Brian Adias. Let's go to Mark Lorenz.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the bout, Brian Adias.